Now let's discuss some advanced issues regarding setting up users and passwords. In this video, we will address the topic of lost or forgotten passwords. Also in this video, we will address the topic of what is an external accountant user. First, let's talk about lost or forgotten passwords. What will happen if a user loses or forgets their password getting into QuickBooks? Well, if you're not the administrator, QuickBooks is simply going to give you a message to contact the administrator. Because remember, the admin user is the one who gives the usernames and passwords and can take them away or give you the ability to change them. However, if you are the administrator, what do you do? Well, your first choice is to answer the security question that you set up when you set up the administrator's password. If you answer the security question, what happens is all password protections are removed. That means everybody's username and everybody's password is removed, and the file is reset as if you never put usernames or passwords on it at all, and you can just use the file normally. Let's take a look at what would happen if we did that. So, here's our file for the Holden Video Company. Let's double-click and open it up. Now notice, as soon as it opens, it asks for a username and password. There we go. Now if I click I forgot my password, all I have to do is answer the security question. Now, when I click OK, I get this message. Your password and challenge answer and question have been removed, and your company file is no longer password protected. When you close this window, you will be asked to create a new password and select and answer your challenge question. So I'm going to click Close, and now it's going to give me the opportunity to again put a new password for the admin. It even gives me a chance to change the name admin to a different name, but I could still be the administrator, and to set up a challenge question again. Now, if you do that, you'll be password protected again, and then you have to reissue all the users and passwords again. If you click Cancel, you can just proceed normally with a file that does not require usernames and passwords. The very next question that students ask is, what if you forgot both your password and the answer to your security question? Well, you could still reset your password with your QuickBooks user license and registration information. If you have to do this, you will have to wait for the QuickBooks company to email you instructions on how to get back in. Let's take a look at what would happen if we did that. We double-click the file and have it open up. And of course, as usual, it asks for the username and password. Okay? If I click I forgot my password, it asks me for the security question. But now, if I click I forgot my answer, now you would put in your license number, which was issued to you upon purchasing your QuickBooks software, and you'd put in all the other relevant information. Then when you click OK, QuickBooks would email to you something called a token, something that you can put into your computer that allows you to reset the username and password as well as the security question. If you're still having trouble, you have to contact Intuit directly, give them your information, and ultimately you will get back into your file. But if you lost both your username, your password, and also forgot your security question, and also misplaced your license number, in that extreme case, you will have to work with the software company on the phone step by step, but you will ultimately get back into the file. Now you may ask, what kind of security features relate to the external accountant user? Well, the external accountant user can do everything the administrator can do except manage other user accounts, such as adding another user, editing another user's permission, or deleting a user, which would make sense. It makes sense that only the administrator can do that. But the other thing that the accountant cannot do is see the customer credit card information. So what we're about to do now is set up an external accountant user. Let's make the external accountant username Sandra, and let's make her password Vasquez61 with a capital V at the beginning and an exclamation point at the end. Once we have the external accountant user, you will see that the only thing she cannot do is see the customer's credit card information. Now, before we actually set up the external accountant user, let's open the customer center and look at this customer, Mary Mania. If I double click, you'll notice in her payment settings, I can see her credit card number. I am able to do that because, as you saw in the previous video, I'm logged in as the administrator. Now let's create an external accountant user and see what happens. From the main menu, click Company, Set Up Users and Passwords, Set Up Users. The administrator still has to put in his or her password. Click OK. And now we're going to click Add User. Now, in this window, the username is Sandra, and the password is capital V, A-S-Q-U-E-Z, 6-1, exclamation point, capital V, A-S-Q-U-E-Z, 6-1, exclamation point. Click Next, and we're going to make her the external accountant. Click Next, click Yes to give her access to everything but credit cards, and then click Finish. Now, we'll see what it's like to log in as Sandra. We're going to close QuickBooks, reopen it, and when it asks us for the username and password, we'll log in as the external accountant. Username, Sandra, password, capital V-A-S-Q-U-E-Z, 6-1, exclamation point. Click OK. And now here we are logged in as Sandra, the accountant. We know that we're logged in as the accountant and not the administrator because if we attempt to open up the customer information, in this case Mary Mania, and we look at her payment settings, we see that we cannot see her credit card information. That's how we know we're not logged in as the administrator. In closing, you should know that there are two things that the external accountant user can do that the administrator cannot do. And if the administrator needs to do that, they need to log off and log in as an external accountant user. The administrator cannot make something called an accounts receivable adjustment. That's an adjustment that a professional accountant will make when they apply their accounting judgment for preparing your books and records for reporting purposes. The other thing that only the external accountant user can do that the administrator cannot do is use something called the accountant's toolbox. The accountant's toolbox will not show up in your QuickBooks main menu unless you're logged in as the external accountant. In order to use the accountant's toolbox, the accountant must be a current active pro advisor in the QuickBooks Pro Advisor program and put in their pro advisor information.